So I don't know if you've heard, but apparently Iran is down one asshole, Soleimani, a name most probably didn't know a week ago, yet whose death they claim will bring about the end of all human civilization. I guess you could say he blew up overnight. This after an embassy attack that stank to high heaven of a put-up job, and the name Soleimani being literally scrawled to the side of the fucking building in the process. Trump picked up the bat phone and droned this dickhead, inciting the iPhone intelligentsia on Twitter to prognosticate that we're plummeting into, wait for it, World War III! An exercise in geopolitical palmistry I'd probably be inclined to take more seriously if it weren't the fifth World War III we were supposed to have in the last 4 years. First, Trump merely running would cause World War III. Then, being elected would cause World War III. Then, bombing Syria would cause World War III, to say nothing of the cock-measuring contest with Kim Jong-un and his Vienna cocktail crank. And now, a glorified fucking thug in thrall to the mullahs vaporized from fucking orbit in a country he wasn't supposed to be in with 11 kinds of foreign fucking currency found in his saddlebag is somehow gonna plunge us all into World War III at last. I can't be the only one who's noticed that every other day there's a fresh new fucking impetus for this narrative. Trump tweeted from the fucking John! World War III commenced! Trump parted his toupee to the left this morning! World War III! World War III! World War fucking III! Folks, even Final Fantasy XIII eventually moved on to another number. Friends, fuck nubs. Where have you been the last 50 years? I mean, have we been watching the same Middle East? The BBC could carve easily a third of the world news runtime if they just condensed those 9-segment gloom and doom factories into the Middle East is still fucked up minute. Hey gang, BBC here. Are my top teeth still fucked up? Then so's the Middle East. In football news, folks, it's the Middle fucking East. You'd have an easier time finding a Persian with an unclogged shower drain than 15 adjacent minutes without gunfire, most of which in no way involves the United States, for the record. And for the goddamn Andromeda brains alleging we're only being attacked because we parked our bases so close to the poor, peace-loving jihadists, fasten your fucking seatbelts because this may come as something of a shock. But the U.S. has bases in nations both hostile and semi-hostile all around this spinning blue bullshit marble, and the overwhelming majority are never attacked. The common element in these attacks is not America. For fuck's sake, they're blowing up Hindu temples and Buddhist temples right now. I mean, where the fuck were you all in 2015 when the Spanish embassy in Afghanistan was attacked by the Taliban? What was the problem there, princess? They declare a fiat on fucking paella? Everyone who's ever played Civilization knows what happens when the computer cries, "Your base is too close to my caliphate." I'll get more in-depth on the issues in Iran, the history of the astroturfed uprising that led to the tanking of what was once one of the great civilizations of the Middle East and the world, but I'll do that once the dust is settled, I think. My position on Iran as of this moment is exactly what we all know now. Nothing. When details become more clear, count on a fucking follow-up. It's more the fully retarded framing of the retaliatory attack into a false binary because of this attack on a terrorist I'm actually calling attention to today. From celebrities proffering room temperature takes from the bottom of a fucking wine cooler to musicians wading into the fray with impossibly nuanced takes, such as Anthrax's dipshit drummer dropping the theory that Trump droned Sergeant Salami to, quote, distract from his impeachment trial. Cunning subterfuge indeed, when you consider that said trial hasn't even fucking happened yet. But allow me to express disappointment in the professionally red-pilled populace on social media and YouTube, who over 4 fucking years had assured us all aloud that social media agitprop has no hold on their opinions or positions, yet swallowed the World War III Ma-Israel proxy conflict narrative harder than Riley Reed at a Winnie Roast. Fuck, I've seen some of these dipshits ovulating about tired-ass, long-disproven stupidity, like the Michael Moore Iraq War era talking point, no war for oil. I shit you not, no war for fucking oil! Next thing you'll be telling me Green Day's making a comeback. Oh shit! Never mind that we never actually seized the Iraqi oil fields under Bush, nor received one drop of oil from the conflict. Incidentally, it turned out to be one of the biggest missteps in American history, as they were ultimately seized by a barbershop quartet by the name of ISIS. Never mind that America is presently one of the foremost oil producers on the planet. Logic, reason, and actual fucking arguments were wholly subsumed by breathless fucking hysteria. Most embarrassingly of all, said hysteria was repeated and promulgated by those on the right who were most insistent they were incapable of being hoodwinked by it. Ka fucking cringe! My favorite part of the media's latest attempt to panic the planet into World War III is where it was reported, unironically, that the most dastardly crime perpetrated on the day was when Trump had the temerity, dare I say, the audacity, to eat ice cream while offing this Iranian asshat. Two scoops, two tomahawks, huh, shit dick? I guess what I'm having the most trouble wrapping my think box about here is, even if he were provoking war with Iran, and I don't believe he is, for the record, what makes this profoundly fucking different from similar retaliatory actions in the recent past? So wait, one surgical strike in Syria isn't enough for the Democrats. I mean, they claimed President Trump was a Russian agent because he refused to go farther in the region. But Iran is allegedly involved in attacking our own property and fucking citizens, and it's suddenly a bridge too fucking far. I say split the difference and find an equitable solution for both war hawks and soy latte socialists alike. Strap the next set of missiles to a pallet of $400 million taxpayer dollars and ship it in the night. You can say you're paying them back for a 40-year-old fucking war debt. Worked for Obama. I'm Razor Fist. God, fucking speed.